myself Dr. Atul Joshi, MD Second Year Scholar, Department of Panchkarma, IPJK NRA, Jamnagar. Today I am going to present a case report on management of frozen shoulder in diabetes through Panchkarma. Introduction: diabetes has emerged as one of the most common non-communicable diseases globally, and it is threatening to be the most challenging health problem of this century. Complications from diabetes such as coronary artery disease and peripheral vascular disease, diabetic neuropathy, nephropathy are resulting in increasing disability, reduced life expectancy and enormous health loss for every society. Among them, muscle cramps, muscle infection, neuropathy, joints, carpal syndrome, tenosynovitis, diffuse idiopathic skeletal hyperostosis and adhesive capsulitis are commonly seen. Among these, adhesive capsulitis of shoulder, also known as frozen shoulder, is the most common manifestation that affects diabetic patients 5 times more as compared to the non-diabetics. Case report: a 64-year-old female patient is at our OPD and complaining of pain, stiffness and restricted movement at left shoulder joint since 8 months. The pain was dull initially, gradually increased in severity, especially exacerbating at night. Around 2 to 3 a.m. Pain usually was aggravating with movements of shoulder and was being relieved after intake of analgesics or with horse fomentation. Gradually the condition was worsened and the majority of shoulder joint movements were restricted. Routine activities including combing hair, bathing, etc. are badly affected. Patient had regular bowel and bladder habits. Appetite was slightly reduced and sleep was altered due to shoulder pain and stiffness. Investigation: routine hematological, urine and biochemical investigation was carried out to exclude other pathology and to know the underlying cause, which were within normal limits except blood sugar level. Procedures: Udvardhan and Jambir Pindsway are done 1st to 5th day to the patient, and Panchatikta Panchatasya Upasthi is done for 6th to 10th day to the patient. Observation and results: satisfactory improvement in overall functional status after 10 days treatment was observed. No analgesics were needed by the patient during the treatment period and 1 month of follow-up. No untoward effects were noticed during the whole procedure. Pain and stiffness was relieved completely by the end of the treatment, with significant improvement in the range of shoulder movement. FPS and PPBS came down from 168 and 93 mg per dl from 232 to 189 mg per dl respectively. No aggravation or pain and or stiffness was reported by the patient during follow-up period or about 1 month of completion of the therapy. Effect of before and after treatment given. Discussion: most of the complications of diabetic mellitus usually intermittent with the various function of visceral organs, but excess sugar in the bloodstream seems to cause other problems, also like musculoskeletal complication, out of which frozen shoulder is most common. In diabetes, the addition of the glucose molecules to the collagen due to extra sugar molecules in bloodstreams can contribute to abnormal